Today our focus will be on the differentiator amplifier using an op-amp. As the name suggests, this circuit will perform the differentiation of the input voltage and we will construct it by using an op-amp. This circuit contains a resistor, a capacitor and an op-amp. In my previous video, I already demonstrated the circuit of op-amp with only resistance and how to calculate the output voltage of that particular circuits. Now we will explore op-amp circuit involving capacitors and we need to figure out the output voltage V0. To begin, we need to know the current equation of the capacitor. We all know this is the symbol of the capacitor C. If this voltage is V1, this voltage is V2, then we can write down I equal to C into dv by dt. Okay. If the direction of the current is this side, then we can write down I equal to C into dv1 minus v2 divided by dt. Okay. So now we will use this current equation to calculate the output voltage V0. Let's assume this point is point A. Now let's apply KCL at point A. You can see this one is the ground, right? So due to the virtual ground, we will get the voltage at point A is 0. Okay. So now applying KCL, we will get 0 minus V0 divided by R. Okay. This current plus C into D0 minus VI divided by DT equal to 0. Why 0 minus VI? As I assume the current will go from this direction to this direction. So let's solve this equation. So we will get minus V0 by R equal to minus C into D of minus VI by DT equal to V0 equal to minus of RC dVI by DT. So this will be the equation of the output voltage of a differentiator, and you can see here the output voltage V0 is equal to minus RC into dVI by DT. That means we are doing the differentiation of the input voltage VI. If we give a triangular voltage waveform to this circuit in the input, then what we will get? We will get the square. Why? As the triangular means T, right? And if we do the differentiation of this one, then we will get 1, that means the square wave. I will do the demonstration by using a simulation circuit in the latter of this video. Okay. Now, this calculation I did in the time domain. So you can see here dVI by dt, right? Now we will do in the frequency domain. So in the time domain, we got V0 equal to minus RC dVI by dt. Okay. Now we need to do in the frequency domain. In the frequency domain, we can write down the impedance of the capacitance ZC is 1 by J into omega C, right? And we know the current I is equal to V divided by ZC. So from here, equal to V multiplied by J omega C, okay? So now let's apply the KCL and see the output voltage. 0 minus V0 divided by R plus 0 minus VI divided by 1 by J into omega C equal to 0. From here you can write down V0 by R minus VI J omega C equal to 0. So from here V0 equal to minus RC into J omega into VI. Right. If you know the frequency domain calculation, then you know that this J omega denotes d by dt. Right. In time domain, we write down d dt, and in frequency domain, it is equivalent to J into omega. Okay. So this is the output voltage expression for in the frequency domain, and this one in the time domain. So it's very simple. Just you need to know the current equation of a capacitor. That is very easy. Okay. Now we will do the simulation of this circuit, and we will see if we give a triangular waveform on this circuit as the input voltage, then what we will get on the output voltage. Similar kind of question we got in the JES 2023. Okay, so let's build the circuit. This is the interface of the AmpliCircuit software. Okay, and here you can see all the components from the voltage source, voltmeter, capacitor, resistor, op amp, everything. Even you can see on the JK flip-flop, SR flip-flop also. Okay, so from here, today our topic is the differentiator, right? So we need to take op amp, a voltage source. So we will take a AC voltage source, as we need to give an input, as the triangular waveform. Okay, a capacitor, a resistor. Okay, so let's connect. And we need to ground all of the components. So we need to check the voltage at the output and as well as at the input. So for the input waveform, I connect a voltmeter parallel to the input source. Okay, and for the output, I connect a voltmeter at the output terminal of an op amp. Okay, so here this is a general circuit of a differentiator. Okay, so let's simulate this circuit. This is the input voltage waveform, and now you can see the input voltage waveform shows the sine wave, right? But what we need to do, we need to make it as a triangular wave. So just change it. First, we need to make it as a square wave. So you can see here, low 0 volt, high 1 volt, right? We want to do it minus 5 volt to plus 5 volt triangular wave. So what we need to do? We need to make low as a minus 5 and high as a plus 5. Okay. Now you can see this square wave at plus 5 volt, minus 5 volt, right? And now the width is 40%. For the triangular wave, the width will be 0%. You can see now it looks like an impulse, right? So what we need to do? We need to make the rise 50% and fall 50%. Now you can see we have a triangular wave where the input voltage of the triangular wave, the max is plus 5 volt, minimum is the minus 5 volt. Okay, and the frequency is 1 kilohertz. We can change the frequency by changing the time period. So let's make the time period 10 microsecond, and the frequency you can see is the 100 kilohertz. Okay. So we already get our desired input voltage waveform. Now let's see what is the output voltage. So this voltmeter indicates the output voltage, right? So just check this voltage. Here you can see the output voltage is the square wave, right? Input voltage is triangular wave, output voltage is the square wave, right? And we already know that if we do a differentiation of a triangular wave, then we will get the square wave, right? But here you can see the maxima and the minima is plus 15 volt and minus 15 volt. Why? As this op amp amplifies the input voltage and already it goes to the plus V saturation and the minus V saturation. Okay, so if we change the capacitor and the resistance value, then this plus V sat minus V sat will decrease to our desired value. Okay, so we already have one question in the JES 2023 where they provide this differentiator circuit and they give this capacitor value is a 2 nanofarad. Okay, and they provided that resistance value is 2 kilo ohm, right? Now you can see we have input voltage of plus 5 volt, minus 5 volt triangular waveform, and now the output is a square wave where the maximum is of plus 8 volt, minimum is the minus 8 volt, okay? Now we will calculate the output voltage and we will show you that the output waveform will be plus 8 volt to minus 8 volt a square wave, okay? So let's go to the pen and paper. So this one is the differentiator circuit, right? Where R is 2 kilo ohm, C is 2 nanofarad, okay? C is 2 nanofarad. And we already know V0 equal to minus of RC dVi by dt. So let's redraw the input waveform. This one we can write down. Five microsecond, and this one will be 5 microsecond, right? So from here we can write down this time will be 2.5 microsecond, and this time will be 2.5 microsecond, right? This will be y axis, and this is the time axis. So if we need to find out the output voltage V0, then we need to know the equation of this curve, that is y equal to function of t, right? So we can write down y equal to function f t is equal to, this is a straight line passing through the origin, right? So from here we can write down m multiplied by t. We just need to find out the value of m. So what we need to do? Y2 minus y1 by t2 minus t1, where this point is the y2, is this is the plus 5 volt, this is 0, okay, and this is minus 5 volt, right? So from here you can write down this point is 5, sorry, the x will be first 2.5 comma 5, and this point will be 0, 0, right? So you can write down 5 minus 0 divided by 2.5 minus 0 multiplied by t. So here you can write down y equal to 2 into t, right? So if we just put this value in this equation, you can write down minus r into c multiplied by d by dt into 2 into t. Here the value of r and c is 2 into 2, right? So we can write down 2 multiplied by 2 equal to 4, and here is 2, that will be the 8, okay? And there is nanofarad, so nanofarad means 10 to the power minus 9, kilo ohm means 10 to the power 3, okay? And this one you can see is the microsecond, right? So this one, it will be 10 to the power 6, why? As this one is the time is the 2.5 microsecond. So here, if we just write down, the y will be 2.2t multiplied by 10 to the power 6. So here it will be also 10 to the power 6. So this 10 to the power 6 will be multiplied here. So you can see this 3 will be cancelled out and we will get plus 8 volt, right? So that's why when you do the simulation for this curve, we just make it red color, for this curve we get plus 8 volt. That means we get this one plus 8 volt, okay? And for this one, what we will get? We will get minus 8 volt. So this will be minus 8 volt. This up to this one is the minus 8 volt. And after this one also, it will go to the plus 8 volt, right? So you can see here, the blue one is the input voltage, is the plus 5 volt, minus 5 volt, and the green one is the output voltage, that is the plus 8 volt minus 8 volt. So now you can see the simulation result is completely met with our calculations. Okay, so that's all for the differentiator amplifier. Okay, our next topic will be integrator. Thank you. Bye bye.